Ready to lose yourself? Fight it or rock with it. My music conquers all. Stay alert.
I don't remember inviting you. Who's the lucky one today? Keep up my tempo! Watch this!
Rules are made to be broken.
Everything is ordained by the stars. Oh, stars, give these trailblazers your blessing! Tough luck running into me! Here!
Oh. Yeah! Ready to lose yourself? You can fight it or rock with it. This is our chance.
A guest with no manners, huh?
Pretty good crowd today.
Turn up the volume. You can't. Turn. Stay right there while I give you a present.
Batter up.
A gift from the stars.
This song's just for you.
Keep up my tempo.
That's it.
Try that again! Gotta try hard sometimes. Check out this awesome move! You have the worst luck running into me!
Perfect. Okay, give me some more of that.
Never expected to find this here.
A lot of enemies here, and we cannot open it. Oh, lovely. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna come back here eventually. But for now, I'm just gonna have to go back and relax. The older town, huh?
There's inspiration in every glance and every breeze.
Oh, you must be Oleg's guests. Welcome to the Gerda Grand Hotel.
Question, do you have a...
Yep. You've probably seen that stylish Gerda hotel above ground, right?
You guys also have a devil inside?
Not the most pleasant memories of that place.
Yeah.
That's the above ground branch of the Grand Hotel. A few hundred years ago, one ancestor of the Gerda family was ambitious and sought to build something big from nothing. He eventually realized his dream and opened a hotel branch in the most expensive area on the surface.
Oh, people with big dreams have big determination.
Yep.
Oleg wants me to take good care of y'all. Here's the key. You'll be staying in our most spacious guest room.
You have a jacuzzi?
What do you think? Should we go ahead and call it a day? Or walk around a bit more first?
Yeah, fuck it, let's go back.
Time to rest again. I hope there aren't any surprises this time.
It'll be so much
that
fun.
That Oleg, he seems sincere. What do you guys think?
Yeah, a parent's gonna be deceiving. Gonna be very careful.
Happy now? She's even starting to sound like you.
It has nothing to do with me. But if you ask for my opinion, it's better to be safe than sorry.
Daichu.
Fine. We'll keep our guards up. Our last hotel experience was eventful, to say the least.
That's one way to put it.
One of us should keep watch tonight.
Keep watch? Are we space cowboys now? I guess this is the cosmic Wild West.
You know what?
Anyone else sleepy? No, I don't. Besides, I've never pulled an all-nighter before. Do you know how bad it is for your skin?
I'll keep watch.
What? You?
Branya, did you finish talking to Oleg? Hope he didn't make things difficult for you.
Did he make fun of your mom?
Though it wasn't the friendliest conversation. We didn't see eye to eye on everything.
Did he spoke about how much of a bitch of your mom is?
I've come to know a great deal in a short time. Doubt I'll be able to fall asleep tonight.
I doubt I'll be able to sleep either. Not that I don't trust you. It's just, you're a Silvermane guard officer in the underground. There might be people looking to harm you.
I wouldn't be surprised if there are. The Silvermane guards have a lot to make amends for down here. If someone had made a stand in the outset and explained the consequences to Madame Kokolia... forget it. It's meaningless to talk about it now. You don't need to worry about me. Oleg guaranteed that I wouldn't be harmed. He seemed like a man of his word. Go and rest.
Miss that still. Okay. He's still putting me straight to the bedroom. Fine. I just have one quest, though. We cannot go and check out the, Okay. Are we done? Fuck this guy. Well, I keep hearing a lot of stuff hitting the metals. So it's not definitely a 5-star. Neutral. I'll just be neutral. Neutral. Yes, this one. I really am actually checking out memory foams pillows. My current ones are not that great at the moment. your friendly neighborhood, Nameless. Yep, everything's in your drawer. I'm done. Again, I am neutral chaotic. Ah, this is perfect. What the?
I lost her. My wish, your so-called plan. What is the point of it all?
What's going on here?
Silence! She is my daughter, my only. You soulless thing. How could you begin to fathom? You will never understand. Never!
Wait, what? That makes it sound like he's dead.
A new world. That voice again. Such a strange dream. May as well go for a walk if I can't sleep.
I guess we are going for a walk. Hey there!
Who goes there? Show yourself!
Calm down, bitch!
Oh, it's you. Don't sneak up behind me next time. Lucky for you, I wasn't armed.
Meh.
No sleep for you either, huh?
Yep.
I understand. The more that weighs on your mind, the more your fears become dreamscapes. Actually, seeing as there's no one around, can I ask you some things?
What's up?
This Stellaron you speak of, if you were to find it, how sure are you that you could stop the Eternal Freeze?
When I 100%, I can truly do it.
Your confidence actually makes me even more worried. This isn't like helping a child make a snowball. You know, it was difficult for me to believe you. Some of the words you use are too alien for those that have lived their entire life in Bellabog. As far as I was concerned,
we are aliens.
Madame Kokolia's order to arrest you sounded reasonable. But why didn't she issue it straight away? She must have realized something about you. Something I haven't yet been able to perceive for myself. It bothers me.
Perhaps.
What must have transpired to cause her such a drastic change? Still, orders are orders. It's not for soldiers to question their superiors.
Oh, yep, only a fool follows our orders blindly.
I don't need you to remind me. And I didn't have every confidence that I was doing the right thing. But the sense of duty to carry out an order is bound to prevail with me. In the past, overworld soldiers on the front line would lose their lives in droves. And yet, the Fragmentum's advance would remain unaffected. Nevertheless, that was her reason for deploying all the Silvermane guards to the front line. The transport line for supplies in Geomero remained open, but the passage between the surface and the underground ceased. I approved of that decision.
I never thought that the underworld would sink into such ruin without the Silvermane guards. Perhaps Mother was wrong.
Yes, she was.
But how can I change her mind? I've tried, but she won't listen. I don't know how to get through to her. Help me change the mind of the Madam Guardian? Not easy. Nobody knows that better than I do.
The more
disoriented I get, which in turn makes me think about it even more. I just want a better life for the people of Bellabog. Maybe you're right. Or not. Right now, I just need more time to think. Walk with me. Let's forget our problems for a while.
What about keeping an eye on... whatever.
I can't remember the last time I went for a walk like this. I never thought I'd take one through such a strange place, with someone I'd only just gotten to know. It's so quiet here. I'm not used to it. The quieter things are around you, the louder they... I'm surprised the vagrants in the Great Mine go after the mining teams. They must be desperate. Still, whatever their situation, a crime is a crime. How is the law supposed to find a balance between justice and compassion in the face of such complexity?
How much longer can you last with your current supplies?
Is that Zila? Let's go take a look.
I know. I'll go to Rivet Town and bring them back for you.
It's too dangerous to go alone. Get Oleg to send someone with you.
The rest of Wildfire has barely gotten any sleep the last few days. They should rest. They'd only be holding their eyelids open and slowing me down. Besides, didn't you say some of the miners were gravely injured? Lives are on the line.
What's up?
Aren't you supposed to be sleeping? What are you doing out here?
Couldn't sleep.
Up to no good, perhaps?
Exactly.
We're just having a walk. Neither of us could sleep. You can rescind your baseless accusations.
I'll ask you to.
Walk somewhere else, then.
Easy, Zila. Maybe they can help.
Yep. I like her.
I'm grateful. Here's the situation. The clinic is packed full of people injured in the mines incident. Since you helped us resolve things, Zila and I have been busy caring for them. As you know, the underground is lacking resources to begin with. Add on the sudden nature of the incident, and it's no surprise that the clinic is almost out of medical supplies. We need to acquire more. Somehow.
The situation in other towns is even worse than ours. As the fragmentum spreads underground, more monsters go roaming around, causing trouble for all the towns. That means more vagrants in the mines. The town's resources have been swallowed up by the fragmentum. To get anything now, people have to risk their lives.
Easy now, Zila. Anger isn't good for one's health.
He also doesn't help.
Zila and I actually aren't from here. We both come from an industrial town to the north. A few years ago, the fragmentum began to seep into the town center. I used to manage an orphanage and clinic there. But after the fragmentum corroded the area, I had no choice but to move here to Boulder Town. After all, I have to survive myself if I want to save more people.
That's
Go to a corroded town to collect some useful resources? I'm in. You want to come as well? But you look quite tired.
Hold up.
It's better off.
I never said you could join us.
People's lives are at stake. Why wouldn't you want another person to help? Besides, I have some experience with the Fragmentums. I'm sure I will be of use.
Well, just don't slow me down.
Zila's lack of outright rejection means she approves of you. With you all accompanying her, my mind will be more at ease. Come, let me give you a list of materials we need.
Got it.
The place you're going to is called Rivet Town. Follow the path through the mountains to the north for a bit, and you'll arrive there. Let me think. I'm almost out of metal plates and bandages used for immobilizing broken bones. There's a market in the center of Rivet Town. Residents left behind piles of materials there when they evacuated. Please look for some there. Oh, also rubbing alcohol. I kept a bunch at the orphanage, since the kids often got into tussles.
Makes sense.
I didn't bring it with me when I left. Oh, I hope it's still intact. Lastly, painkillers. There should be a bunch stored in the old lab. Hopefully they haven't been destroyed by monsters. These should be enough to get by for a bit longer. Be careful. Don't push yourselves too hard.
Metal plates and bandages, rubbing alcohol, and painkillers. Got it. Piece of cake.
Yep.
Let's go. If we leave now, we can still make it back before sundown. When it comes to helping injured people groaning in pain, the sooner the better.
Aren't you, like, on the ground?
If we hadn't happened to be passing by, were you really planning on going into the Fragmentum alone?
Of course. What's all the fuss about? I've done that loads of times.
Oh. So reckless. According to the rules of the Silvermane Guards, any expedition into the Fragmentum must have a squad of at least 4 members, as well as a communications officer.
Exactly. A rule of the Silvermane Guards. Don't apply your rules to us.
That's right. Don't forget, we are underground. We are not in the above surface. All right, then let's go.
We're here. This is Rivet Town. Everything looks familiar. Let's go, and watch your step. I haven't been here in a long time. There are probably some monsters around. We can't see anything here. Let's find higher ground to get a better view.
Completely deserted. Kinda sad. What the?
Way over there. See that house on the hill?
You mean the big mansion?
That's Natasha's old orphanage.
Oh, that's an orphanage.
After Oleg found me, he sent me there. I spent over half my childhood in that place. Natasha said that the house was donated by some rich businessman. Whatever his business may have been, he must have been a good person. I miss those carefree days as a kid.
Huh.
What? Nothing to say?
No, it's just... this place seems familiar somehow. Never mind.
Oh, here, that's right.
Weirdo. Look down there.
The
see the mess that remains of those old stalls? That's Rivetown's market. The supplies Natasha wants are probably there.
Yeah, don't worry, I'll
Let's
find
keep
it.
Moving. Watch out for monsters.
Yeah, correction. The monsters should be watching out for me. But yeah, the nightmare was talking about the girl, daughter, gone or dead
Careful.
Or something.
Enemies ahead. These aren't like vagrants. They won't...
Don't treat me like a new recruit. I'm all too familiar with the monsters of the Fragmentum. Let's get ready to fight.
Yeah, we got this.
This
ready
is our
to
chance.
Lose yourself? Fight it or rock with it. My music conquers all!
Batter up!
Nice.
You couldn't have done it without me.
Got some treasure.
Restaurant?
The most famous restaurant in town. Natasha would bring the kids who behaved well here for a special meal.
Oh.
So, did she ever bring you?
Do I seem like I was a goody two-shoes? Of course not.
Well, eventually, no one's coming here. Hello! I was not expecting this guy.
Let's make it quick.
Scared yet?
A gift from the stars.
Okay, there you go.
Reach nice. The end of the story in your own way. Is that all?
The facilities here seem to be in pretty good shape. Not like those of a place that has been abandoned for years.
Now that you mention it, it does seem a little... Could people still be living here?
What?
Impossible.
But we don't see anyone here. And there's monsters all over the place.
Looks good.
There's a bunch of crates piled over there. Watch out.
Everything is ordained by the stars.
Oh, profound secrets of the stars! Give these trailblazers your blessing!
Take this!
Rules are made to be broken.
You've outstayed your welcome!
Ready to lose yourself?
Fight it or rock with it. My music conquers all.
And done.
You couldn't have done it without me.
This is our chance.
For inviting you. Who's the lucky one today? Keep up my tempo. couldn't have done it without me.
Oh, what have you said?
Darn. What? How could they all be empty? Now even the monsters are gathering supplies?
Maybe the monsters of the Fragmentum
don't need any materials we humans use. And if they did take anything, this place would look much messier.
You mean that someone else got here and took everything before us?
It's just a guess, but there are also some footprints on the ground here.
The scent of dirt is still fresh. They can't have come too long before us. Let's go then. We need to find something, even if we have to search every corner of this market.
Okay, so let's keep looking. Hello. What?
Eric? Hey, Brat! How could you come here by yourself? Don't you know how dangerous this place is?
Zila! You aren't the boss of me. I can go wherever I want. It's none of your beeswax.
Beeswax?
You took the materials and hid them all here. Not bad, kid. But if we didn't take care of those monsters, what were you planning to do? Just stay here, shaking in your boots?
Who asked you to do anything? I was just about to escape. I didn't need your help at all.
Still stubborn, huh? Then tell me, how exactly were you gonna get those big metal plates out of here past those monsters?
Yeah, how are we gonna do?
There's always a way.
Yeah, that's enough. He's just a kid.
Let him fool you. Everyone in the underworld knows that this brat is a no-good thief. If I remember correctly, even the clothes you're wearing came off another kid's back.
Usually?
About that.
Tell us, what do you even want metal plates and gauze bandages for? We need them to save people.
200.
What?
200 shield?
Are you kidding me? You want to negotiate?
It's just 200. But I never bring my coin purse with me on a mission.
You're actually planning to give this little crook money? I'm telling you, this is his same old trick.
No! Not this time. I really need money. My daddy.
Pretending to use your dad again as an excuse. If he knew about this, you'd be in big trouble.
No!
Zila, that's enough.
Yeah.
It's Eric, right? Here, you can have this.
What's this?
This is a medal given to me by the architects. See that blue stone in the middle? That's a geomeral crystal of the highest purity. You need money for your family, right? Take this and show it to a knowledgeable buyer, and they'll instantly know how valuable it is. But you'll have to promise me one thing. You'll never steal other people's things again. Promise?
I promise. I'll never steal things again.
Then it's a deal.
Hey,
if you go back on your promise, I'm going to bring my Silvermane guards with me and catch you myself. Here, take the medal and go back to the town. We already took care of any threat on the way. You'll be safe.
Thank you, whoever you are. You guys can take all of these things. You guys need to be careful, too. There seems to be something real scary in that house up on the hill.
What?
Oh, right. The road across from the market is blocked. If you want to go further, you'll have to go to the shopping street.
That's nice.
Got it. Thanks for the tip.
That object was pretty important to you, right? Are you sure you're okay just giving it to Eric like that?
If it will make him change his ways, it's more than worth it.
What if he doesn't?
From a young age, my mother taught me to be forgiving and to preserve the goodwill in people's hearts. Even if I am but a small glimmer of light in this world, I must try my best to shine brightly for others. I must give him a chance, Zila, because other people can't.
I don't really get what you just said. Anyway, we should get moving.
I think you do get it.
Eric said that we need to take the shopping street to go any further. I think I still remember where it is. This way.
Right. I am curious. Didn't mention the house in the hill. It makes me wonder.